हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीएससी सिक्स मास्टर, सो वेलकम टू फिजिक्स क्लासेस बाय सरबदीप कौर सिद्धू. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टॉपिक दैट इज क्लॉशियस मोसॉटी रिलेशन. दैट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिलेशन इन डाइलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल्स. एंड इन दिस वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द रिलेशन बिटवीन द मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज एंड माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज. मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटीज दैट इज एप्सिलॉन और यू कैन आल्सो से एप्सिलॉन, ठीक है, बिटवीन एप्सिलॉन एंड अल्फा. और इन सम बुक्स देयर इज एप्सिलॉन आर एंड अल्फा. एंड अल्फा दैट इज अ पोलराइजेबिलिटी, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिकल पोलराइजेबिलिटी, एंड दैट इज अ माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी. एंड दिस एप्सिलॉन दैट इज अ मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी. ठीक है, सो एज वी नो दैट the dipole moment that is directly proportional to when dielectric is polarized, when we apply electric field, then dipole moment that is directly proportional to E local field, clear. And P is when we put here equal to, then this is alpha, this is directly proportional, this is alpha, and this alpha is constant of proportionality and is called the electrical polarizability of the atoms. Clearly this is electrical polarizability of the atom. So polarization of an insulator containing, if that dielectric or insulator that containing n types of atoms, then total, when we have to find out the total polarizability, then that added up of the individual atoms. If we have n types of atoms, then capital P that will be equal to summation from I equal to 1 to n, ni alpha I e local, alpha I e local ni, where I is equal to 1 to n for n types of atom. Clearly, so e local we take it outside, summation I equal to 1 to n ni alpha I. Now we have done in the previous article that E local that will be equal to E plus 4 pi P by 3. That we have done in the previous article, that E local is the sum of four types of electric fields, and for isotropic material we have taken that EM is equal to 0. Clear, because they have a symmetry. And after that we have find out that E local is equal to E plus 4 pi E. P by 3, where P is the polarization. Clear, see? So you'll put the value of E local here, then we have P is equal to E plus 4 pi P by 3 summation I equal to 1 to n ni alpha I. Clear, see? So from this you can find out the value of P by E. From this you can find out the value of P by E. How you can find out the value of P by E? Taking the values having P on one side. So that is P minus 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I equal to 1 to n, I am not writing here, into P, okay, is equal to summation I equal to 1 to n ni alpha I E. Clear, see? So I am putting the value of E local. E local is equal to E plus 4 pi by 3. So when I multiply E by this here and taking this 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I on this side. From this you can find out the value of that you can say P over E. We want P over E. So how we can find out the value of P over E? By taking 1 minus 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I P, that is equal to summation I equal to 1 to n ni alpha I into E. So from this you can find out P by E. So P by E that is equal to summation I equal to 1 to n ni alpha I upon 1 minus 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I. So this is the value of P by E. Clear, G? Now we have also know the relation between epsilon and susceptibility, or epsilon r or susceptibility if you want to put epsilon, and there is a relationship between epsilon and polarizability p or susceptibility, that is equal to epsilon r. We know that is equal to 1 plus susceptibility, and if we are taking epsilon, then we have a relation that is 4 pi p by e. 4 pi p by e, that is susceptibility also. We are taking 4 pi. If you are taking epsilon, then you have to take 4 pi p over e is equal to epsilon minus 1, or from this you can find out the value of p by e. So p by e from this, that is equal to epsilon minus 1 over 4 pi. So this is also the value of p by e, and this is also the value of p by e. So taking both, we can take equal. So when you take both equal, what you get? We will get that from that two equations, we get that a summation ni alpha I upon 1 minus 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I, that is equal to epsilon minus 1 over 4 pi. So this is the relation. Now from this relation you can find out the value of epsilon. So from this, epsilon comes out to be, epsilon is equal to, taking 4 pi, 4 pi summation ni alpha I, theek hai ji, 4 pi over 1 minus 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I. This is epsilon, 4 pi over this, minus 1 means here will be plus 1. This implies epsilon is equal to this. Now, in this epsilon, this is the value of epsilon. Now, if you add plus 2 in the denominator and subtract minus 1 in the denominator, for example, in this value, you will have epsilon, na? Epsilon is this, epsilon minus 1 over epsilon plus 2. Epsilon minus 1 means you have to take this value of epsilon, then taking minus of this, minus 1, upon same epsilon of this plus 2. When you do this, you can do it in the rough work, then what you get? You will get that epsilon minus 1 over epsilon plus 2, that will be equal to 4 pi by 3 summation ni alpha I. Clear? Ni alpha I. So this will be the relation when you subtracting minus 1 and plus 2 and then taking like this, you will get that this relation, and this is the Clausius-Mazzotti relation. If you are having epsilon r here, you will use in that relation epsilon is equal to 1 plus susceptibility, and that will be equal to epsilon, from this epsilon r is equal to 1 plus p over epsilon, you have to take there that, then at that time epsilon minus 1, instead of this you have to take here epsilon r minus 1 over epsilon r plus 2, you will get something different from this value, and that will be equal to n alpha over that is equal to 3 epsilon naught. Clear? When you put I equal to 1 to n, after putting you will get this n alpha here, n alpha over 3 epsilon naught you will get. Instead of 4 pi, you will get 1 over epsilon naught. Clear? See? Same ni alpha, you can summation ni alpha, or you will write n alpha. Clear? Now, if all the atoms are, which have a dielectric, all the atoms are same, if all the atoms are same, ye sare atoms same hai, all the atoms are same, then what can we do? Then we write summation ni alpha I is equal to n alpha, like this. If all atoms are n alpha, you can write here. And for that, what will be the value of n? N will be rho na over m. M is the molecular weight. This is the molecular weight. And that you know, all of you know that. Na is the Avogadro number, and rho is the density. Okay? Avogadro number, that is nm over rho, you know. Okay? So from this, you will get the value of n, and you can put here. So from that, what will be the value? That is epsilon minus 1 over epsilon plus 2, that is equal to 4 pi by 3. This is n alpha. So putting the value of n, if this, rho na over n. over n. 4 pi by 3 rho, putting the value of n, rho na over m into alpha. Clear, ji? And you will take m on this side, taking m over rho, epsilon minus 1 over epsilon plus 2, m over rho. This, that will be equal to 4 pi by 3 alpha into n. And this is also Clausius-Mossartti relation. And this relation is connecting two quantities, that is a macroscopic quantity, epsilon r, if you are using this, and epsilon in this. Epsilon, that is a macroscopic, and alpha, that is a polarizability, electrical polarizability. Okay, ji? And this relation, if we know the value of epsilon, you can find out the value of alpha. And if you know the value of alpha, you can find out epsilon. And if the relation is in epsilon r, you can find out epsilon r, dielectric constant. Clear, ji?
So thank you very much.